structure located in Italy has a base area of 6 acres, which is about 15 square miles. Its name, according to a rounding tourist, originated from the Neo Age statue and supposedly has magical qualities. Today, the Roman Colosseum is a major tourist attraction that houses about 4 million visitors each year. This summer, I had the amazing opportunity to travel to Rome and visit the Roman Colosseum. While I was there, to prepare this speech, I recalled information I learned on a guided tour and conducted research in various databases. The Colosseum was built as a grand amphitheater for games and ceremonies in ancient Rome. First, we will look at the formation of the Colosseum. Then I will discuss what the Colosseum was used for. And finally, we will look at how it got to be in the form it is today. Let's look at how the Colosseum came into existence. The Roman Colosseum was originally built around 70 AD by Vespasian and then was finished 10 years later by his son Titus. It was the grandest amphitheater built during that time. The outer walls rise up to be about 50 meters above ground and about more than 100,000 cubic meters of travertine stone were used, and just the metal clips holding the stones together weighed more than 300 tons. Each arch on the second and third level surrounding the Colosseum held a statue that related to classical mythology. It is a completely self-supported structure. It is not built into the side of a hill or mountain like most structures were during that time because they did not have the technology. Built in a broad valley, the Colosseum stands at the center of Rome where it still stands today. According to the book Rome, Past and Present, the Colosseum could hold about 70,000 people, including standing spectators. There are 80 arches at ground level where people may enter. Then there are left through corridors to one of the 160 outlets that took each spectator to his or her seat. An unbelievable system of passageways is built underneath the arena, meant as a backstage area which contained elevator lifts that moved people and animals around. Now let's look at what this amazing work of architecture was used for. The Roman Colosseum hosted events such as naval battles, animal hunts, and gladiator fights. According to Guimard Farvi, sea battles were routine occurrences. Evidence illustrates the arena being filled or flooded with water and while horses swam in it, or for the sea battles, many ships advancing toward each other in fight. After they stopped having naval battles, that section of the arena was then turned into the backstage passageways. The animal hunts were also a very popular event. Exotic wild animals such as lions, elephants, and rhinos were used. The animals would be held in dark cages underneath the arena until they were raised up and let out to the arena through a trap door. As told in the book Rome, there was one instance where 100 lions were released into the arena at once, and their combined roar was loud enough to stun the crowd into silence. The most common and popular event were the gladiator fights. The owners of the gladiators spent lots of time and money to prepare them for the fight and hopefully win. Most of the gladiators were slaves or prisoners of war. Some of them fought to the death, while others only to the first wound, depending on the emperor, the owners, and the crowd. As explained in the NBC video. The video also told about the hand signals that were used to tell if the gladiator was fighting to the death or not. Sadly, the gladiators were not really considered as men during that time. They were more closely related to animals. The Roman Colosseum continued its ceremonies for a few centuries. Then the Colosseum began its downfall. Gladiator fighting was abolished in 438 AD. This was their main event, so obviously it hurt the attendance, which lessened their funding and income. The last show containing only animal hunts was in 523 AD under King Theodore. Another factor was that the Colosseum began its dissension architecturally. Natural causes such as earthquakes weaken and damage the structure. Also, one emperor decided to make use of the abandoned structure and has demanded that stones be taken away from it and used to build other buildings in Rome. This was eventually put to a stop when the next emperor came into power and decided it should be preserved. Now only the north side, as pictured here, stands to its full and original height. In conclusion, the Roman Colosseum is symbolic in its formation, utilization, and dissension. Over the years, the Colosseum has maintained much of its said magical attributes, as most people would agree with. You can definitely see why it's such a huge tourist attraction that it is today. There's no other structure as grand and impressive as the Roman Colosseum in its structure and functions.